That looks to be about it. Oh, the body search. Since you were locked in the interview room the whole time, there really doesn't seem to be much point in that. You can go back to the recreation room now if you want.
Thanks.
I'm sure she'll be fine.
I hope so. It might be selfish, but I don't know how I'll manage if she doesn't make it. My God, what's happened?
Well, this is it.
I know. Now, you take care of yourself, May Collins.
You too, love.
I'll wait, Harold.
I could have sworn this was my cell.
Yeah, well, since you're so big on manners, we've come to teach you some.
I don't think there's a single thing you could teach me, Kelly.
You reckon? Well, we're going to teach you how to treat a top dog, for starters.
I don't care what you call yourself. You stay out of my way. You mess with me again, and I swear it'll be the last thing you ever do. Got it?
Hey, what happened?
Nothing. Why?
They give you some trouble?
What, them two?
You mean you took on both of them?
Hey, look, honey. I don't go around looking for trouble, but I'm not taking it from anyone. They leave me alone, I leave them alone.
Anyone who can take on Kelly and Lurch without batting an eyelid has got what it takes in my book.
Yeah, but it takes more than muscle to make a good top dog.
That's why I reckon Rita would be okay. I mean, she was really good with Daphne when she was down, and the women seemed to like her. She knows how to make them laugh.
Look, we don't know much about her. She's a bikie. They're hardly known for their care and understanding.
And I'm a murderer, and you're a thief.
Point taken.
Look, anyone who can handle Daphne the way she did can't be all bad.
Look, she's only on remand anyway. She'll probably be out in a couple of weeks.
So? A lot can happen in that time. And anything's better than having Kelly take over.
That's true.
Oh, my God, she's white as a sheet.
That's pretty normal after surgery.
But she's in a coma, the doctor
said. But that's not as bad as it sounds. The operation's been a success and she's going to be fine. Isn't that the important thing?
I know she wouldn't want me to worry, but I just can't help it.
The doctor said that the coma will probably only last a day or so.
But what if they're wrong? What if she never pulls out of it?
My whole world had collapsed around me.
What's the long place for, Dad?
Oh, nothing. Just that Willie used to watch this show all the time.
Wonder where those two got to, eh? Remember Willie talking about going back to Paris?
With the brains that pair have got, I reckon they'd just about be riding into Whoop Whoop by now. Yeah.
Here on mule. Hey, you want a game? Never say no. Take a ride.
Hey, what's on?
Just some dumb soap opera? We're all sitting here resting our bums.
Yeah, Barbie's the only one who's interested in it.
Oh, is that right? How can you tell? How you going, Barbie, me old mate?
The other way around.
You like the show?
Can you forgive and forget me playing around?
Hey, how are your plants going, Dad?
Oh, good. Well, Rowan is going to pull through, but the others are sort of touch and go. And Linda's definitely had it.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear.
What's she doing here?
Huh?
Well, what's she do to get in?
I don't know.
Nobody does.
Hey. We ought to run a book on it, you know. What's my crime? 50 cents a guess and winner takes half the pot.
Half?
Oh, well, there are certain running costs involved, you know.
And what if she's already told somebody what she's in for?
Oh, yeah. Barbie, you told anyone what you're in for?
No.
Oh, great, because, you know, one thing you don't do in the nick is ask anyone what they're in for. Isn't that right, Dad?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, can you do us a favour? If anyone tries to make you tell, you let us know, OK?
Yeah.
Right, ladies, the book is now on. Come and place your bets.
I reckon it's shoplifting.
Yes?
More likely abstracting a psychiatrist in the course of his duty.
Is that your guess?
Oh, come off it. This is going to take a lot of thought.
Would you agree?
Hell, we should have started later. Anyone walking down the lane can see right down here.
We've been through that enough times. They tighten security at 11. This is our best chance.
Go round to the emergency exit and wait for us there.
Don't forget the audio. You cut the wires.
Yes, I know we've been through it.
First green, then blue,
then yellow, I know.
Listen, man, if you don't trust us, you can climb up the hard way next.
6 minutes?
6 and a half.
First.
Who is it?
Come in, Tom.
What are you doing here? They're at the gallery now.
It's okay. I just wanted to see if you're right.
They're looking after May. Anything could happen.
Well, I've got my orders. Look, I have to keep clear so I don't blow the cover if...
What? If anything goes wrong?
Nothing's going to go wrong.
You can't guarantee that. Listen, we're only doing this because your people and Reynolds said that we'd be looked after. Now, how can you look after May if you're not there?
Stop worrying. She'll be all right.
On this?
Sure, why not? Don't have to get council approval now, do I?
You'd run a book on anything.
Oh, come on, Nora, it's just a bit of fun. I mean, 50 cents a guess and winner takes all. Well, almost, eh?
What do you think, Julie?
I don't know. It could be something really clever, like a well-planned robbery.
Oh, you've got to be joking.
Oh, but she might be. It's probably an act. She could be hiding something.
Yeah, sanity, I reckon. What do you think?
I'll think about it.
Yeah, well, don't take too long, eh?
Where are you going?
Good guy, the toot. It's being a woman again. Hey. Waiter, taking a few bets already, eh?
Yeah, sure, why?
10%.
Huh?
10%? That's what you give me for letting you run a book.
You gotta be joking.
That's 10% of the bets, not your cut. Get nicked.
Oh!
Wise up, Patterson. You ain't got Norma Council to go to anymore, so don't risk crossing me.
Yeah, all right, all right!
Everything all right, Patterson?
Yeah, fine, Miss Morris.
Yeah, we was just talking about an old movie that was on the telly the other night. Where are we, Lexi?
Yeah, you know.
Yes, well, you can act out your fantasies some other time. It's lock up now. Back to yourselves.
No worries, eh?
And Kelly, you know better than to bring a cue out of the rec room. Put it back. Right, back to yourselves, ladies, please. Quick as you can.
Any news on Mrs. Barry?
Yes, she came through the operation, but I'm afraid she's in a coma.
Oh, no, is she going to be okay?
Doctors aren't sure yet.
That could mean brain damage.
But surely there's no danger of her dying.
No, thankfully not. The doctors are hopeful that it won't last more than a day or two.
We'll be thinking of her.
Right, come on, back to yourself.
Mrs. Morris?
Yes?
I have to see my solicitor.
All right, I'll phone first thing in the morning.
No, oh, no, it's urgent. I have to see him tonight now.
It's nearly lock-up.
Yes, but it's really urgent or I wouldn't bother you. I thought I was entitled to see my solicitor any time I wanted.
Yes, you are, but there are limits. All right. I'll phone tonight, but don't expect him to turn up. Solicitors do have social lives, you know.
Thank you.
Better check the corridor.
There's no patrol for another 20 minutes.
They could change a routine for crying out loud. Hey, maybe we can take out a few of these other pieces too.
Don't get greedy, Sonny. That is worth more than that whole lot put together.
Come on, what the hell are you doing?
He's doing his job. I'll leave him alone or he'll be just as jittery as you.
Sorry.
Mind if I come in?
Sure.
6 bloody months old anyway. When do you make your appearance?
Dunno. Couple of weeks, maybe.
Reckon you'll get off?
2 chances. Buckley's and none. Police have been looking for an excuse to put me away for years.
So you'll probably be around for a long time.
You better get used to my smiling face, honey. Aren't you the lucky one?
This isn't exactly a social visit.
I didn't think it was.
Oh. Taking a bit of money, I see.
Oh, give us a chance. Haven't been around all the girls yet.
Well, fair enough. Just give us what you got so far. 20%.
20? You said 10, huh?
Yeah, but I've changed my mind. Top dog can do that.
Yeah? Well, I changed my mind too. You can take it off the $100 you owe me.
Oh, no, we're square, I told you. Now, come on, pay up.
Rack off!
Come here, you bitch!
My problem is I tried too hard. Then we tried...
Two one to one, eh? Yeah, that'd be your style, Kelly.
I'll rack off your bucky mob. You get yours, Connors, when I'm ready.
See what I mean?
Ah, there's always someone who's ready to try it on.
You just don't let them get the better of you, that's all. Those women aren't as strong as you.
So what do you want me to do about it? Wet nurse them? Forget it. It's number one I look after.
You got mixed up in Lexi's problems.
It's just a stir, Kelly.
Oh, lock up, Nora. Come on, back to yourself.
Yeah, right away, Mrs. Morris. Look, I was the same as you. I didn't want to get mixed up in the women's problems, but I got dragged into it. You will too. Kelly will see to that. The women need someone like you to be head of the family.
I've got my family. The Conquerors. They're not just a mob of bikers. They're part of me. They're my life. I've got no time for a bunch of headless chooks looking for a hero.
What the hell are you doing here? Well, Jim, it's you. I'm glad you're here.
Pity I can't say the same.
Look, I'm very tired and very worried. I don't want to row with you.
She's my mother, Pringle, and you're not a relative.
Your mother's the woman I love, and that's why I'm here. That's why I'll stay until she pulls through.
Get out. Or I'll get them to throw you out.
Please keep your voice down.
Go to hell! You broke up our family, Pringle, but you're not going to come between me and my mother.
You're talking nonsense, and you know it. If you want to start a row, we should at least go out into the corridor.
I'm not leaving. You're the one that shouldn't be here.
When your mother wakes up, she'll want to see someone she knows and loves. And after your behavior at your father's funeral, I'm not sure you're the right person. Sorry, Jason.
We did it. May. Oh, it's you. Well, we got it. And the Yanks should be pleased. It all went without a hitch. What do you think, Willie?
Oh, it's exquisite. It's just divine.
There's been a change of plan.
Oh?
Mr. Cooper's found his own buyer. He won't be needing a fence.
What? No, we agreed I'd be responsible.
I know. He's changed his mind.
So what's the story?
I'm taking it back to him tonight.
And we just sit tight here waiting for our money? I don't think so.
Oh, no. No, Mr. Cooper said I could pay you now.
Put the gun down.
He just killed her. He shot her. She didn't stand a chance.
We've got him now. Willie, there's no point in you spending the rest of your life in prison for filth like him. Now put the gun down.
Okay?
Yeah.
Well, it's all over, Willie. You'll be all right now.
I should have killed him when I had the chance.
Now you've done well. You'll get your pardon, have a bit of cash behind you.
May thought so too.
She didn't die for nothing, Willie. We've got enough evidence on that yank to put him away for a long time. And his cronies. That went slipped through our fingers this time. Keep an eye on it tonight. We get this whole thing tidied up, will you?
Sure.
I'm sorry about that before. I was upset, Robert.
Look, it's all right.
Dad's dying.
You don't have to explain.
Think she'll be all right?
I just have to trust the doctors. I don't know what I'll do if anything happens to her.
I know. She seems happier with you than she did with Dad. I suppose that's a bit hard to accept sometimes.
She's very proud of you, you know.
Yeah, well.
Look, there's another chair. Why don't you wait with me, and then when she wakes up, she can see the pair of us.
Yeah. Thanks, Levin.
Well, I'm sorry to disturb you so early, Mrs. Reynolds, but I thought it more appropriate than a phone call.
Quite all right, Inspector. The local police phoned.
So you know about May Collins?
Yes, I thought you had the situation under control.
Well, we did. It was just one of those unfortunate incidents. Well, what can you say?
How's Beecham?
Hasn't been hurt, being looked after. The department thought it best to go ahead with the pardon, so she won't have to come back to Wentworth. The minister will get the papers to you today. There'll be a press release explaining about the robbery and the arrest of the American. Of course, as we agreed, Willie's name won't be mentioned.
I see.
We're trying to get the whole situation cleaned up as quickly as possible.
All neatly packaged up and filed away under forgotten.
Well, hardly that, Mrs. Reynolds.
No. I've lost women before. Heroin addicts, prison riots, murders. No matter how many times it happens, you always feel shocked. Guilty in some way. Responsible.
Where would you like to work?
You really going to do it?
Well, of course. Who's going to stop me? Nora.
Rita May. Oh,
she's only here on remand. They're not going to back someone who's going to be walking out of the joint in 5 minutes. Now, where would you like to work?
Repairs, I guess.
Nice,
Nathan. Right. Jacko, you're on the washing machine. Flynn the dryers. You're doing the folding. And Young, take the skipper.
What's Lurch doing?
Repairs.
Oh, that'd be right. Nice cushy job, eh, Lurch? Get to rest your big fat bum all day, eh?
Shut your neck, Connors.
I say whatever, whenever I like. Get it?
Yeah, well, if you can work as well as you can talk, we should get a lot of work done today. Well, come on, what are you all standing around for? Get to it.
Getting sleep?
No.
Look, Carr, the minute I get the word, I'll take you downtown and get everything fixed up.
To collect my 30 pieces of silver.
Hey, come on, you earned that reward.
I did nothing, May did it all. Look what she got. We should never have trusted the police.
May knew the risks as well as you did. She thought it was all right.
No, she didn't. She didn't want to do it. We were talked into it.
Hey.
Tricked into it. By that inspector and Mrs. Reynolds.
If anybody's to blame, it's that Yank. He'll get what's coming home.
Don't worry, Mr. Hardy. Everyone responsible will get what's coming to them.
Good morning, Miss Wilder.
Good morning, Mr. Adams.
Eve, what's wrong?
She knew. Mrs. Berry knew I had to do it.
Mrs. Berry?
I did it for you. She was going to tell the governor your career would have been finished. Nobody suspects me. I had the perfect alibi, but you have to get rid of these.
Oh, no, no, no.
David, I did it for you, for us. You have to help me.
But what's the point if she comes out of the coma?
She can't. Think of our lives together when all this is over.
What do you mean?
Look, they don't expect her to come out of the coma anyway. And even if she does, she'll just be a vegetable. Don't I mean anything to you? We have our whole lives ahead of us. David, there is only one way out.
Yes. Right, thanks for letting us know, Mr. Pringle.
Bye-bye. No change.
Better than bad news, I suppose. The waiting's the worst thing.
No, the worst thing is that Keane pulled the wool over our eyes, and now Joyce Barry's suffering. Mr. Adams, sign out if you don't mind.
Hi.
Oh, fine, thank you.
Hope the wedding rehearsal goes well this afternoon.
Yeah, it's 3 o'clock, isn't it?
No, 12:30, I think.
Ah, yeah, I'll be there.
Ladies, you amaze me. You just haven't thought this through at all.
It was a no-win situation, for us, anyway.
That's right. Alive on the inside or dead on the outside. Inspector Gordon's assured me that this man would follow you and keep as close to you as possible at all times.
That's right. Any sign of trouble, he'll be there. He'll get you out.
Mrs. Morris and I are witnesses to that promise.
All right, Governor, you've talked us into it. When do we start?
Hello? I'd like a cab, please. To go to Wentworth Detention Centre.
Oh, poor Willie. They were so close. There won't be any publicity, so there's no reason for the women to find out. And Willie? She won't be coming back. Her pardon's coming through and they're arranging resettlement. Any sign of Joyce's keys? No, not yet. Well, it won't do them any good. All the inner locks have been changed.
Yes, I've got to explain the locksmith's bill to the department.
Oh, by the way, Lou Kelly was working the press this morning.
Trouble?
Too early to say.
Keep an eye on it, mate.
Yes, I will. Now, what do you want me to do about Keane?
Did she say what she wants to talk to me about?
No.
Oh, I'll go up and see her now.
Come here.
Gotcha! Sorry, should have knocked.
Well, Mason Evans with this one. She just can't keep her hands off me.
Well, if that is your attitude. Any sign of David yet?
Well, I hope he's not too much longer. I'm supposed to be in court this afternoon. Judges are handing down a decision on Daphne's case.
And I've got my last lesson at Wentworth. Certainly going to be sad saying goodbye to everyone.
Yeah. Well, did he know what time it was?
Yeah, when I phoned Mum, she said she reminded him this morning. I hope he hasn't forgotten. He seems to have a lot on his mind lately.
Yeah, well, Eve Wilde's enough to distract any man.
About it all night, and I didn't do it, you see. And
that's
I...
not what the evidence points to.
No, but look, I like Mrs. Barry, and I couldn't have hurt her like
Keen.
That.
Keen, we've been through all this before. You asked to see me. If you've got nothing new to add, it is simply a waste
no,
of
time. No, but there is, please. I want to ask if I can see Dr. Wiseman.
Why?
Well, I've got to get someone to believe me. He listens to me, and he can
there
tell you
no
that I'm innocent.
There is no point in seeing Dr. Wiseman now, because there is nothing he could do.
Oh, please, I've got to talk to someone.
You can talk to me if you're prepared to start telling the truth.
Oh, but I am. I couldn't have heard her like
we
that.
We have given you every opportunity to prove yourself reformed. Dr. Wiseman has been professionally compromised because you chose to ignore that opportunity. Do you understand?
Yes,
one of my best officers has been brutally attacked and come very close to losing her life.
I didn't do it!
Now, listen to me, Keen. You are going to have to learn, like everyone else, that you'll have to accept responsibility for your own actions.
Sorry I'm late.
Oh, that's all right, pal. Pippa and Jen have gone on ahead. We'll meet them there.
Right.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I'm just...
Things on the mind, eh? Well, cheer up. You had to drop the case. It was moral obligation.
I didn't.
You're still representing him. Mate, you said you'd call the police. You have to. You're finished if you don't. David, you are my friend. Listen to me, please. I'm just worried to see you tearing yourself apart over this woman. I'm not the only one to notice. Ever since you met Eve Wilder, you've been... Your whole attitude's changed to everything. Your work, your career is just falling to pieces. And you're not even trying to find a way out.
I have changed. The whole situation's got totally out of hand. Oh, God.
Can I help you?
I want to see the governor.
You got an appointment? Beach?
Yes, I want to see the governor.
Stay right where you are.
I see. All right, let her through. Oh, and, Bob, there'll be an all-staff memo later. She's been pardoned. She's not an escape prisoner.
Are you happy now she's dead? Is that what you wanted?
Really?
Is that what you were hoping for? That neither of us would come out of this alive?
Really, what are you talking about?
I knew how dangerous it was, but you talked her into it.
Willie, please calm down and we'll talk about
it. Rot for years in prison if we didn't go along with the plan. Well, what choice did we have? But May knew. She just knew.
I didn't mean you. It was always your decision to make, yours and May's.
We're as upset about this as you are, Willie.
Can you be? She wasn't your friend. You didn't see her wiped out in front of your eyes.
I just didn't want you to miss the opportunity. I thought the police could handle it.
She never would have agreed to it if you hadn't carried on about the police being there all the time. At all times, your exact words. You sent her out to be killed. You murdered her, just as if you'd pulled the trigger yourself.
Control yourself, Pitcher. You're
upset. I have a cup of tea, Mrs. Morris. Okay.
I might pick some flowers and give them to Mrs. Barry.
That'd be nice, Daphne. Oh, yeah, that'd be real nice, Daph.
What a bloody use that'd be.
Drop dead, Kelly.
Well, if anyone was going to do something useful, they'd get the bitch who put her in hospital in the first place.
Reb's in the pound, didn't you know?
So?
So when he gets out, we'll have a score to settle.
Oh, yeah, and what are you going to do? Give her extra cleaning duties? You know, the trouble with you is you got no imagination.
You got a better idea?
You'll see. Now I'm top dog, we'll get a few things done. Rather than just sitting around talking about them. Hey, Miss Ferguson.
What is it, Kelly? Any news about Mrs. Barry? No change. Why are you so interested?
Well, the women think a lot of her. She's all right. I suppose she'll be a vegetable if she pulls through, eh?
I can't see you losing any sleep over that.
Oh, fair go. I don't like to see it happen to anyone. Especially because of that nutcase Reb.
Oh?
Yeah, the bitch. Jeez, I'd like 5 minutes alone with her. But it's a bit hard, seeing as she's up in solitary and me not being on trade duty and all, you know, it's...
Sounds to me like you're asking for favours, Kelly.
Oh, no, Miss Ferguson, I wouldn't do that.
Oh, I think you would, Kelly. And I think you should get extra duty as punishment. Lunchtime trade duty.
Thanks, Miss Ferguson.
Don't thank me, Kelly. You don't get anything for nothing.
You know your pardon's through.
And the money. Not much use if you've no one to share it with. Mrs. Reynolds, I'd like to see Nora.
Well, I don't think...
Please, I need a friend, someone I can talk to.
I suppose... Mrs. Reynolds, can I see you for a moment? Do you think that's wise?
She needs someone, Meg.
I don't think Nora would talk to the other women if we ask her. Maybe
can you
she's
risk
responsible.
It? They were so close to me.
Perhaps you're right. Apart from that, the whole operation is supposed to be kept secret. Her attitude towards you is appalling. I mean, we'd be in a lot of trouble if she passes that on to the women.
Yes.
I've spoken to Inspector Gordon. He's sending Tom Harley around to collect her. The sooner we get her out of here, the better.
I know.
Willie, I'm afraid I can't let you see Nora today. I think we should speak to Inspector Gordon first.
I need my friends, not the damn police.
I think it's best for the time being. I'm sorry.
Tom Harley's coming around to drive you back into the city. He'll be here in about 15 minutes.
You can stay here.
I'm not going anywhere with him. How do I know I can trust him?
I think you're being...
You're trying to sweep it all under the carpet, aren't you? You and the police. You had it all planned between you, didn't you? And it didn't quite work out. I didn't get killed.
Oh, control yourself.
You can't keep me here. I'm not a prisoner anymore, and I want to leave.
Take her out, please.
Why should I keep my mouth shut just to save her neck? I want to talk to Nora!
Mrs. Slattery, take Miss Beecham to the front door.
What the hell's going on? First she escapes, and now
the
you're...
The governor will explain later.
Perhaps you'll let me speak to Julie.
I'm sorry, you're not allowed to speak to any of the women at the moment. Just take her to the front gates, will you? I'll look after the problems.
But the women are already outside on recreation.
Look at that great, big, wide, wonderful sky. Oh, I'd give anything for a run on my 74 today. Oh.
What's the matter, Dad? You're a bit jumpy today.
Oh, she's expecting the verdict on her appeal this hour, you know.
Yeah, they said sometime today. I thought I heard Slattery say they'd be giving you another 20 years.
Don't take any notice of her, Daphne. She's only pulling your leg.
No, it can't be.
It's Willie.
Willie.
We were supposed to go free. The police are making us do
that. All they were doing.
May's dead. It's all Reynolds' fault.
You heard what I said. Is that true? What she said? Mind your own business. Move it.
May'd still be alive today. Reynolds tricked us.
Move it!
Well, I tried to get her to stay here and wait for you, but she kept insisting she was a free woman.
Yeah, you'd have to let her go.
She was in a very emotional state.
I can imagine she's, well, she's very frightened, and without May, I don't
think...
What's
going to happen to her?
Oh, don't worry. We'll help her as best we can.
Is there anything we can do?
Mrs. Reynolds, she's upset about the accusations.
Yes, yes, she is.
Yeah, well, I'll better go and see if I can find Willie. She can't have gotten far.
Well, let us know what happens.
Sure.
It's a bit of a mess, isn't it?
Yes, yes it is.
fair.
You reckon it's true?
Of course it's true. Willie wouldn't make up a story like that.
I wonder what happened.
We'll probably never know the full story now.
Yeah, well, whatever happened, Reno talked him into it.
Yeah, so much for her being concerned about us lotting here.
Cops, screws. They don't give a monkey's for anyone on this side of the bars. I reckon someone ought to front the governor and find out the full story.
Yeah. That's a top dog's job.
You'll be lucky. There's nothing in it for her.
Kelly, report to the kitchen.
What for?
You heard me? Now move. Don't push your luck.
Yeah, well, I've got to make it look good, haven't I?
That looks really great on my record. Two prisoners escaped from my custody, and now you tell me it was all arranged by the police.
I'm sorry, but they wanted as few people to know as possible.
But I was involved! I mean, I thought you could have trusted me enough to have
let me in. I'm sorry, of course I can trust you, all of you. It was an unusual situation, and I'll make sure there's nothing in the files that's detrimental to you.
I'd hate to think what the union would say if they found out about it.
Now, the governor's explained what happened, Pat.
Yes, I know. I'm sorry.
Police put a lot of pressure on us.
Yeah. Well, better get back on my rounds then.
I hope the women are as reasonable as that.
Somehow I don't think they will be.
Somehow I think you're right. I hope they find her before she does any damage to herself, otherwise I'll have two lives on my hands.
Oh, you don't think that she...
I don't know, Meg. I'm not sure I know anything anymore.
It's not your fault.
Isn't it?
I'll have to think of some way you can pay me back, Kelly.
Oh, I'm sure you'll think of something, Miss Ferguson.
But I'll tell you this for free. Don't be fooled by Eve Wilder.
Oh?
Yeah. Beauty on the outside, cunning bitch underneath.
Isn't it always the way?
Yeah.
I'll give you 2 minutes. Don't leave any marks.
G'day, Red.
How's it going?
All right.
Things have been happening while you've been up here.
I'm top dog, man.
Oh?
Yeah, and you're not too popular with the women for smashing poor old Joyce's head in.
Oh, but I didn't do it. I wouldn't do something like that.
Well, the screws reckon you did. Oh, and the women reckon you did. That's why I'm here. To even up the score for poor old Joycey.
If anyone wants me, I'm just slipping out to get something to eat.
Right, Mr. Prindle.
Reno's coming to tell us about Willie and May.
Oh, food is bulges more likely.
She must have been pretty popular with everybody.
Yes, she was. Auntie May to all of us.
You reckon there'll be a blue?
No. Well, here Reynolds out.
That's a pity. I like a good stout. What do you reckon, Top Dog?
Well, like Nora said, we should listen to what Reno's got to say.
Well, it sounds to me like you're soft peddling.
No way. As a matter of fact, I've just been up in solitary settling a score with Reb Keane.
You what? Like I said, I believe in action, not talk.
Quiet, ladies! The governor wishes to speak to you. Just pay attention, will you?
A couple of weeks ago, the police approached May Collins and Willie Beecham and offered them freedom in exchange for their help. I'm not at liberty to go into details. But today, Willie is a free woman. May, unfortunately, didn't survive the...
No. Oh, what happened to her?
Quiet, ladies! Quiet. How did she die?
She was shot.
Yeah. Oh. Shot? Who done it?
I can't tell you at this point.
Well, then whose fault is it?
It was no one's fault.
Oh, sure. Never is anyone's fault.
I'm as upset about this as you are.
Well, just be quiet and listen
well,
to the governor.
Well, tell us what happened, Mrs. Reynolds.
I can't do that.
Oh, it's a bloody whitewash.
Maybe they didn't have a chance at all. Maybe you sent them out to get killed.
That's ridiculous.
Kill her! Kill her!
Fight of my life when I got back and you weren't there. I thought you were out pulling another job. Is that where you're going, back to your room? I'll give you a lift if you want.
Why should I trust you?
Because you can, that's why. I don't know what you said back there, but I think you upset a few people. You know?
Perhaps that's what I wanted to do.
Ah, come on. Scream at me if you have to, the whole police force, but don't blame Mrs. Reynolds. It wasn't her fault.
She pushed us into it.
No, she didn't. You know what I think? I think you're trying to palm off your guilt.
What have I got to feel guilty about?
You didn't shoot the bastard to kill May, that's why. You have to live for yourself now, Willie. You got to live your life, you know.
What life? What bloody life?
It's the way May would have wanted it, isn't it?
May was the only friend I ever had. The only real friend.
The women in Wentworth care about you.
No, they don't. They'll forget about me. They'll forget about May. Even Reynolds will forget about what she did to us. I'll never forgive her. Never.
Willie, what you do, you get yourself a job, a nice little flat, you buy yourself some new clothes and you start again, right? Why don't I take you back to town? I'll buy you some lunch and we'll talk about it. What do you say?
No, thank you. I'll make my own way back. Only two people ever cared about me. My father and May. Now I've got to learn to be alone.
The sun.